إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أحسن الكلام كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد Indeed, all praises are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him Azza wa Jal in the manner that which only He is deserved to be praised with. We praise Him, we seek His aid and His assistance, and we seek and turn to Him in forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil that is within ourselves and from the evil that is in our actions. Whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed with guidance, there is not a single person on the face of this earth that can turn them astray. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed and left to go astray, there is not one person, there is not one group of people, there is not one nation that despite their best efforts can return that person to the truth. I bear witness that there is no God, there is no deity, there is no being, there is no thing that is deserving and worthy of the right to be worshipped except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and his final messenger, who was sent as a rahmah, who was sent as the best of examples, the best of teachers, the best of guides for us to follow, who was sent as a bearer of glad tidings and a warner against the punishment and azab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, He says, وَتَزَوَّدُوا وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing us. He is addressing us whenever we are about to embark on a journey, whenever we are about to set out on a task, whenever we have something that we need to get done. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, He says, tazawwadu, that take provision, make preparation, take the time to gather the things that you will need so that you can accomplish your task, so that you can successfully arrive to your destination, so that you can successfully achieve what it is you are setting out to do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He does not leave it at that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. He says that the best of these provisions, the most important thing that you can take when you prepare, the thing that should be at the top of your list, فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى, that it is taqwa. Ya ikhwan, having the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our hearts, it is something that it is of the greatest and most precious qualities that you can possess. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, Inna Allah yuhibbul muttaqeen, that verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves the muttaqoon, that He loves the people who have taqwa. He loves those who fear Him. He loves those who are conscious of Him. Ya ikhwan, is there anything that we could desire more than this? Is there anything that you could wish for that is greater than being considered a friend of Allah Rabbul Alameen? Is there anything that is greater than attaining the love of the one who has created this entire universe, the one who sustains this entire universe? This is the rank that we can have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if we strive and struggle to attain taqwa. This brings us to the very important question. What is taqwa? What is this precious quality that we all strive and we all desire to have? Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he was asked this very same question. When the man came asking him, he asked the man a question in return. He asked him, he said, have you ever come across a path that is thorny? The man said, yes. So he asked him, he said, how is it that you traversed this path? How did you get through it? How did you cross these thorns? And the man, he said, that every single step that I took, I was careful and cautious so that I would not step on any thorns. Every single move and every single movement that I made, I placed such a great importance in knowing where these thorns are so that I would not touch them. I paid such care, I had such caution when I walked through this path, that I did not even want a thorn to be caught on my clothing. So Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he tells him that this is taqwa. That same care, that same concern that you had in avoiding the harm that those thorns would afflict upon you, that is the same care. It is the same importance that you must place on avoiding the sins, avoiding what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited you from doing. Many of us today, we know that if we go to a certain place, or if we are with a certain group of people, or if we look at something, if we hear something, if we listen to this thing, if we look at that, that it will cause us to fall into sin. But we do it anyways. We do it anyways. Where is the concern? Where is the high importance that Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu is speaking about here? Instead of having a care and concern for avoiding these thorns, we will just see this thorny path and run straight through it without a care in the world for the harm that it will cause us. Every week when we come to the khutbah, we sit and we hear the khatib. He begins his khutbah. He says, يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله. Every week we hear him, he mentions these ayahs of the Quran, and we pay them no mind. We listen to them and we say that that is just something that he has to get through before he can tell us what he really wants to tell us. Rather, that is the important thing. That is what is most important. The khatib, he begins and he says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ. That fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the manner that you are supposed to. Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, when he comments on this ayah, he says that fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the manner that he is deserved to be feared, it entails three things. Firstly, it entails that you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and that you do not disobey him. That you obey him in what he has commanded and that you do not disobey him by doing what he has prohibited. Secondly, it is that you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and that you do not forget him. That throughout your day, you do not forget that you are a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And finally, he says that fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the manner that he is deserving to be feared is that you are thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and that you are not ungrateful. Many of us today, ya ikhwan, we live without a care in the world about the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We go to work, we go to school, and we struggle and we strive in attaining this dunya. We make maximum effort in attaining the best of this dunya. And we forget why we were put in this dunya. We forget why we were created. The only reason that we were created is so that we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yet in our daily lives, we pay him no mind. Many of us, if it wasn't for the fact that we have to pray 5 times a day, we would not even remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for some of us, even when we stand in salah, our mind is all over the place. Our minds are racing. In a hadith that many of us may know, Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu, he mentions an incident, he mentions an occasion where Jibreel alayhi salam, he comes to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the form of a man whilst he is sitting amongst his companions. And he comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam and he asks him some questions, the purpose of which is so that he may teach the companions about their religion. He says, Ya Muhammad, akhbirni anil ihsan, that inform me, tell me, what is ihsan? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says, الإحسان أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. That إحسان, it is that you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you can see him in front of you. That you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if he is in front of you. Because if he is not in front of you, know and be certain that he is al-Sami', he is al-Basir, he is al-Hakim, he is al-Alim. Be certain and know that he sees you. He knows every single action that you do. He knows every single thought that crosses your mind. Instead of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if we can see him in front of us, many of us, when we stand for salah, we think about this, we think about that, we are planning for this and we are remembering that. We stand for salah and we wonder, it is amazing to us why we are unable to focus, why our salah lack khushu'. We wonder, it is strange. The answer is very simple, ya ikhwan. Having khushu' and having that taqwa, that consciousness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you, it is not a switch. It is not something that can be flipped on and flipped off whenever you want. If you spend your entire day without remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without thinking of Him, without giving the utmost importance to making sure that every action that you do is in accordance with the commands of Allah, and in making sure that you are staying away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited, if you do not give importance to this, if you are not conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how do you expect that in the 5 or 10 minutes that you stand in front of Him, you will be conscious of Him, and that you will worship Him in the way that He is meant to be worshipped? It is not a switch, ya ikhwan. You can't spend your entire day without remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala outside of the salah that you are going to perform, and then expect that when you stand in front of Allah, you will have perfect khushu'. The only way to achieve this khushu' and to actually benefit and enjoy your salah is that you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly throughout the day, so that when you are in salah, you are not struggling to now try and know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you, to now begin to realize that you are standing in front of Allah and that you are His slave. It is too late to realize that when you are standing in your salah. Rather, that must be your mentality throughout the day. Know that you are a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That your only purpose in this world is to worship Him. And only then will we finally learn how to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if we can see Him in front of us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق أجمعين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد. أيها المسلمون, achieving and attaining the taqwa of Allah, attaining this consciousness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always watching you, it is not something easy. It is not something that you turn on like that. It is something that you must struggle and strive and make effort every single day to attain. The first step in making that effort is that you take account of yourself. Be honest with yourself. How much of your day is spent in remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If you pray and you take 5 minutes to perform a salah, then at most, at the very least, half an hour of your day is spent in remembrance of Allah. Out of 24 hours, half an hour. How much of your day is spent in the recitation of the words of Allah, the Quran? How much of your day is spent in the dhikr of Allah Rabbul Izzah? How much of your day do you spend showing gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ, that remember me and I will remember you, and be grateful to me and do not disbelieve. وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Ya ikhwan, if we were to return to the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this task of attaining taqwa will become so much easier. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his life, he has shown us so many instances throughout the day that we can remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we go to the bathroom, when we enter our own homes, when we begin to eat, these are all times and places throughout our day where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has shown us certain dua, certain adhkar to make. By doing this, if we were to implement each and every one of these things, if every time we got in our cars to travel to go somewhere, if every day before we went to sleep, we recited what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us to, just look at how many more instances throughout the day you have spent, even if it is for a couple seconds, in the remembrance of your Creator. Look at how much more you can remember the one who created you. Look at how much more time during the day you can spend in the remembrance of the one on whom your very existence depends upon. Be honest with yourselves, ya ikhwan. Reflect upon how often you are conscious of your Lord. And if it is something that you feel you are lacking in, then the final step to attaining that taqwa is that you increase in these actions. Increase in your worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Increase in your salah. Increase in your dua. Increase in your dhikr. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he says that the signs of taqwa in a person, that the thing that can show you the level of taqwa that a person has, is his care and concern in his worship. That if you want to know the level of taqwa inside yourself, how concerned are you? What importance do you place on worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the manner that He is deserved to be worshipped? How much care and concern do you have that every single action that you do, before you perform it, you ask yourself, am I acting in accordance with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command? And how many times before you do something, do you check yourself and make sure that you are not doing something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited you from doing? Ayyuhal Muslimun, this issue of taqwa, having this consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is not something to be taken lightly. Like Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu mentioned, that every step that you take, every move you make, be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be conscious and give care to what He has commanded you from, to what He has commanded you to do, and what He has prohibited you from. Give such an importance to the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, like the man with the thorns, you do not even want one to cling to your clothing. That you do not even want to be associated with any type of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many of us, when we disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we make a mistake and we commit a sin, to us, it is nothing more than as if a fly had flew across our faces. It flies, it goes its way, and we pay it no mind. Yet the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they would commit a sin, it is something that would eat at them. It is something that would bother them. and they were the best of this nation, then what is our status, ya ikhwan? Ya ibadallah, if your sins do not bother you, then know that your taqwa is lacking and that it is something that you must work hard to achieve. Ya ikhwan, having the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart, it is something precious. It is something that needs to be guarded. Remember, the next time that you feel like staying away from something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded, remember the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised you. Remember what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised the muttaqeen. Your promise is Jannah, ya ibadallah. And know, be certain, لا يخلف الله الميعاد, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He does not break, He does not waver in His promises. I ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase myself and all of you in His taqwa, that we are all able to attain these higher levels of consciousness and know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us. I pray that He allow us to give the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the utmost importance, that we stop looking at them as suggestions, but rather we look at them as something that we must do. And if we do not do them, it bothers us. I pray that He allow us to stay away from what He has prohibited. And I pray that He counts us from amongst the muttaqeen, from amongst those who are conscious of Him, from amongst those who fear Him, and from amongst those who have ihsan, from amongst those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if we can see Him in front of us. رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنَّا كُنَّا مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الدين ودمر أعداء الدين اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقيموا الصلاة